Hey boys, welcome back to some more Roosters Career Mode Season 2 here, taking on the Melbourne Storm for Round 18. We're still on top first, the Storm are coming 7th. A little bit of a surprise, obviously they're a very strong team. It's going to be a tough game. Obviously the origin period is now finished, which is nice. I'm happy about that just due to the fact that I can't get confused with what round and what game we're playing. But yeah, it's good to have also all the players back. William Hopewadi, a new signing for the Storm, not a bad player to bring in. It strengthens their side quite a bit, I would say, because that's probably the only one area where they were a bit weaker. Maybe, you know, they had a good like back three, and then Will Chambers one center, but then the other center was a bit of a, you know, it was either fucking Ryan Morgan or Chase Blair. But Hopewadi, not too bad. But John Bateman here is going to score the first try of the game. A bomb goes up and it was just perfectly batted down by, I think it's Billy Slater. And just Bateman on the spot there just read it perfectly, executed nicely, and the opening try. We couldn't really, honestly, there was nothing we could really do about that. It was just too good, really. So going down 6-0 early in the game, not the kiss of death yet, of course, as Billy Slater here just turns it inside out, gets it to Cooper Cronk, and he's going on an angle here. It was so confusing, and I just couldn't line it up. I tried to, you know, I pressed the button to, like, make him tackle, but it just, I don't know, I mustn't have been close enough. But Slater, he linked up with Cronk, and Cronk was just going sideways. I know, when this happened in game, I was like, what is he even doing? Like, I've never seen the AI do that. Like, you know, sometimes they do go a little crossfield, but that time though, he was going like full diagonal stuff. It was clever play. He was trying to, you know, make ground. And then a good last tackle kick here. Ferguson eventually gets it, throws a risky offload. You know, we're down 12-0, but we're still going to chance our arm. But yeah, 12-0 down. We just, you know, we haven't really done too much wrong. It's just been, the Storm have been on absolute fire. It was Kenny Dowell here. Gets a beautiful offload. Cordner, another one. Gets it to Ferguson backing up. I thought it could have been a nice try, but probably, you know, we'll take the fact that we didn't knock it on or throw a forward pass there, so not the worst result. As last tackle here, 77 meters gains, a good little kick out dummy half. Actually, it's a pretty shocking kick. Jordan McLean there just takes it in goal. It was a little too deep, didn't give the chasers enough time to get hold of it, as Guerra gets it onto Dale Copley, gets it back to Guerra, going for the troll line, gets it to Daniel Tupou there, gets tackled. But we got another little opportunity here. We try that little play back on the inside. It could have actually worked if I pass that off the left to Daniel Tupou. We had a lot of space out there, but I didn't quite see it during the game. As our fourth tackle, we put in a decent little kick, and I wasn't too sure. They called a knock-on here. Must have been a Storm knock-on, and we're going to get the line dropout, so a bit of back-to-back pressure. And, you know, that's probably what we need. We need to just tire out the Storm defense a little bit, get them on the back foot, and hopefully, you know, we don't need to claw our way back, 12 all in this first half. But getting that initial try will go a long way. Is Guerra here, throws the dummy, beautiful little bit of play. I always screwed it up. I was just going to throw the dummy and go straight through, but Slater obviously was just going to take the man with the ball here, and just threw the pass to perfection. Dale Copley just plants the ball down on the spot, and it was a nice try. It was just well worked, and good stuff by Guerra. Didn't panic at all, threw the perfect pass, as we do claw our way back. So 12-6 leading into the halftime break. I'm pretty happy with that, because the Storm, the start of this game was just on fire with nothing, not much we could do. But an absolutely shocking kick there, last tackle, gave us a slight opportunity to potentially counterattack, but it was snuffed out pretty quickly. Starting the second half off, we get a good opportunity to press the attack. Good offload there to Cody Nikorima, going for the little gap there, but gets met right there by the Storm defense. But on the back of that, it was good little play there. Just had them on the back foot from the get go, and then just feigned to go to the open side, pass it back across the face of the ruck to Ferguson, and it was a pretty easy try there. The Storm defense just converged into the middle of the field and just opened it up. As right here, we get a couple of nice passes away. corner down the wing here. I decided to put in a little kick. Probably not the best option, especially the fact it was corner kicking. But I just thought it was we could pin them in the end goal. Didn't quite work out that way, but it was still not a bad kick. As last tackle, we put the bomb up. But who was that? Corabetti there takes the bomb. And it's a shame that Corabetti is leaving the NRL. I mean, he's really starting to find his feet, but, you know, he's going to Union. Just, why do you do it? But Will Chambers here, just killing it. And he's just going to go straight through. The funny thing is, I just made, like, a video, I think for Beer Pro, and Will Chambers was playing for the Broncos, and he absolutely destroyed us. So it was... It was a bit of deja vu when Will Chambers just went straight through the defense right there, and it puts the, as he goes through again here, Chambers just, he's very, very good in this game, just can't stop him, but it puts the Storm into the lead, a 6-point lead, and they get the last tackle kick there, almost a game still. That could have been the winner. Billy Slater gets the ball, some large dish tackle right there, so we do have an opportunity to fight our way back once again. We just, I thought when we got back to 12-all, I thought we would probably run away with this game, but, you know, just the Storm, they've played very well this whole game, and they're able to peg another one back and just further extend that lead. So we've never really been able to just get on a good consistent roll as Daniel Tupou down the sideline. I thought we had Slater beat, but then he just drags us back like 5 meters. Crazy stuff. Last time we put the bomb up, Kenny Dowler knocked down, and Heimel Hunt just didn't quite get to the ball. I actually liked that a lot. It was like, it was cool just because, like, it was a good knockdown, but it just quite, Heimel Hunt was just slightly behind it. Otherwise, it could have been the mat or the, you know, the leveler. But we're going to get one last play, one throw of the dice here. Ferguson going across field, gets it to Dale Copley onto Daniel Tupou, but he's absolutely nailed by Corabetti. And the Storm win 18-12. It was a pretty decent game. I mean, we didn't play badly. It was just the Storm. They took it to us. Hopefully you guys enjoyed, and I'll see you next time.